Today we're going to be talking about a quick three-step progression to achieve a proper stooping position. So what is a stoop? If you look at the side, you're going to stoop is when we have ourselves in a nice neutral position. We push your hips back while keeping the lower back neutral, and we have our weight in our heels and the hamstrings and glutes loaded. So for some of us, it's actually a very, very difficult time achieving this position just because we lack the kinesthetic awareness or that mind-body connection to actually make this happen. So we have a quick three-step progression that'll allow you to get into this position safely and effectively. So the first one I'm going to show you is the hollow body hold. So the first thing we're going to do when we actually get ourselves ready to stoop or bend from the hips in from the hips is setting that midline position. So a quick little drill here. We're going to lie on our back. Okay. Naturally, we have a little bit of an arch to our back. What we're going to do is we're going to rise our legs up in the air, keeping our legs as straight as possible. We should be about perpendicular to the ground. If you lack hamstring flexibility, you're naturally going to be a little bit bent here, okay? We're going to do the best we can to straighten out those legs. Now from here, I'm going to reach up with both of my hands and the upper back off the ground. So I'm holding this position here. Now I'm going to lower my legs down as far as I can, right before my lower back begins to release from the ground. I'm going to hold this position here. Then I'm going to squeeze my butt, and all of a sudden, I feel a lot of tension in the midsection, and I feel this lower back neutral. Go ahead and relax. You're going to hold that for about 15 to 20 seconds to really get that effective hold in the midsection and feel how your body becomes neutral when you squeeze your butt and you lock down that core. So that's step one. It's called a hollow body hold. That's a gymnastics movement. Very, very, very simple. The second step in this progression is finding your heels, okay? So this is a great little drill. You can do this with a partner. If you don't have a partner, you can just do this on a pole or a rack of some sort. You're gonna take your hands, you're gonna put this on the rack, you're gonna take a few steps away. Naturally, as your arms extend, you're gonna reach your hips back, okay? And keeping yourself nice and tight, you're gonna reach into your heels. Lift your toes up. You're going to reach your butt as far back as possible. What we're doing here is we're cultivating the idea that you're reaching back with your hips. You're not bending from the lower back. So you're going to reach your hips back as far as you can and get those heels. The stoop takes place in the heels, and this is what that teaches you. And then finally, we're going to put this all together by taking a PVC or a broomstick. You're going to take your PVC. You're going to line this up with your back, so you're basically your head, shoulders, lower back, and butt are going to be in alignment. From here, I'm going to get that hollow position, so belly tight, rib cage down, squeeze the butt. Now I'm in a nice neutral position, my feet are underneath my hips. I'm going to have softness in my knees, they're not going to be locked out on my bone. Softness in the knees. Now I'm going to kind of put together what I just did. I'm going to push the hips back, keep the belly tight, as far as I can, until I feel that stretch in the hamstrings while staying neutral. Common fault here is as we start to come back, we'll unload the hamstrings and start to flex more back. We don't want to do that. We want to push back as far as we can while keeping those legs straight, feel the stretch in the hamstrings, and then come all the way back to the top. If you follow this three-step progression consistently and work on that hamstring mobility, you have no problems getting into a full hip hinge position. Thanks a lot, guys.